Well, it was the news that shocked the nation, that the Queensland state government sought advice and considered cancelling the Brisbane 2032 Olympic Games. Premier Stephen Miles was quick to deny the claims, making a bold declaration at question time yesterday. We're joined now by Minister of Sport, Annika Wells, live in Canberra. Minister, good morning to you. Thanks for your time this morning.
Morning, Carl.
Look, the 2032 Olympics are 8 years away, eight short years, and this was supposed to be Brisbane's time to show the world how we've come of age. Now it's just a national embarrassment. How are you going to stop it being an international embarrassment?
Well, I think, firstly, we've got our OCOG meeting tomorrow, which is, I think, a really timely time for everyone with a stake in this to get around the one table and have a discussion about the pathway forward. I mean, you make the point, Brisbane's had more years than any other host city by the IOC to prepare. And it's a shame that things have come to this point where Queenslanders and Australians are unhappy with where things are at in terms of the preparation for the Games. We don't want that. I want people to be looking forward to this. I know as a Queenslander, I was so proud when we became the host city, and I still think, Carl, that it will be what you say, which is a real coming-of-age moment for Queensland. But I think, you know, and I put up my hand, all of us with a part to play in this are going to need to do more and work harder to demonstrate to people that we still can make this a coming-of-age moment in a really special time.
You work really hard at this portfolio. No one can deny that. But this is under your watch. You must be livid about how things have gone.
I wouldn't say that, Carl, because I do, like you say, have a very, you know, a closer eye than anyone on all the different elements that make this a complex thing to put on. And games are messy. I mean, I can't wait for Paris, but as you'd well know, they haven't even decided how the opening ceremony looks at the moment. You know, they don't know how many athletes will be participating in the open ceremony and what format. These things are always a bit untidy on the road through. But what, like, I think it's such a privilege that I get to do that, like you say. And I want to make sure that people feel like this is value for money and that this is something that they welcome. And, you know, remember with the Matildas last year, that really wasn't on the radar for a lot of Australians until it arrived, and then it was this national uniting moment. We can still have that.
OK, our athletes say the QE2 reboot will cost us medals. Kate Campbell yesterday, she went off, and rightly so. Liesl Jones today also saying it was playing politics. They're upset, and they've got every right to be so.
Look, we've talked about this before. When I make decisions as federal sports minister, I am always athlete-led. So the moment I hear that athletes are concerned, I am concerned as well. So that is something that I'll be raising. And it sort of speaks to, I think, the broader question this week, which is that we all need a lot more detail about what this new format and what this new proposal looks like. From the federal government's perspective, we need the costings. We now have to vary an intergovernmental agreement and agree to the new venues being proposed or that have been decided by the Queensland government, and we're going to need a lot more details and specifics before we can do
what
that.
What a mess. So you mentioned the Olympic organising committee. It meets tomorrow. We've got Paris, we've got LA. I mean, we can't talk on behalf of the Olympic committee, but anything less than great would be a massive concern to them, I'm sure. I mean, the very future of the Games rides on world-class events. And I'll put it to you, there's nothing world-class about whacking a bit of spit and polish on QE2?
Well, I would say what is world-class is what we at the federal government have committed to do for the Brisbane 2032 Games, which is the $2.5 billion Brisbane Live venue. You know, as a Queenslander, you would have come to my beautiful neck of the woods, Boondall, for live indoor entertainment. It is as the steward of Boondall that I sadly say, like, we do need a better fit for purpose inner city world-class facility, and that's what we are contributing, and that is a good legacy piece for Queensland and for people who want to come to Queensland for live music. The other legacy pieces, the smaller venues, the minor venues that will sit around the different suburbs and regions of southeast Queensland, they are also good value for money and good legacy pieces.
Okay, it just doesn't make any sense to me when you're talking about opening and closing ceremonies at Suncorp Stadium at 50,000 capacity. Buck the Bronco runs out of space on any given Sunday, let alone 10,000 athletes. It's just embarrassing.
Good luck tonight, first of all, and secondly, it's the new norm. Let's call a spade here. We're having a frank conversation, and I appreciate it. Mm. Brisbane's the smallest city to ever have been awarded the host city rights for the Olympic Games. We wouldn't have got it, but for the new norm protocols, which the IOC have put in place, because the world is changing and taxpayers don't accept what they used to when it comes to sports infrastructure funding. And under the new norm protocols, we are supposed to refurbish existing venues first, and I imagine that's what has led the Premier to the Queensland Government's decision, and that is theirs to own. But for us at OCOG, when we meet tomorrow, I think it's a good time for us to get around the table and really talk honestly about what you're talking about regaining the trust of people.
Okay. To your knowledge, have there been any breaches of contract yet, given the look of the games compared to the pitch?
With respect to the host questionnaire, we're not actually a host party. Complicated, but Brisbane and Queensland are host parties to the IOC, not the feds. So I don't see those contracts, but we will now, I can tell you, have to vary and sign a new intergovernmental agreement between the Queensland government and the Australian government.
I've got no problem with the federal government, but I have no faith. I have no faith in the Queensland government in delivering the games as it stands right now.
And I think that feedback has echoed across the state this week, has been heard loud and clear. And like I say, whilst I'm here in Canberra today, I'm looking forward to flying home and being part of that honest discussion at OCOG tomorrow.
Queensland Premier Stephen Miles is in damage control, declaring the Olympics in Brisbane will be the best games ever after Nine News reported his cabinet considered cancelling Brisbane 2032. Joining us to discuss is Olympic legend Liesl Jones in Brisbane. Good to see you, Liesl. Thanks for your time this morning.
Good morning.
Now, this is an absolute shambles, isn't it? I mean, stadium changes, ditching the games. You're an Olympian. You know how important preparation is. Is this acceptable?
It isn't acceptable, unfortunately. And look, every Olympic Games has had their issues in the lead-up. I'm sure Sydney had their issues beforehand, talking about transport, longevity. But this is the Games that I feel have been the most embarrassing. Brisbane has been the butt of all jokes for many, many years. And this is our opportunity to really step forward and put Brisbane on the world map. And I think we've fumbled it so far, unfortunately. It's disappointing to see because Brisbane is such a wonderful city. I mean, look behind me. It's so beautiful. And during COVID, everyone moved here. Mm. They realised what a wonderful place Brisbane is, and we have royally fumbled it.
Well, absolutely. And as you say, on a global stage, do you have any faith that they can undo the damage?
I think they can undo the damage. We have plenty of time to be able to prepare for an Olympic Games. We still have another 8 years, and time up our sleeve is a great thing, but we are running out of time. We need to make decisions on where we're going to host it, what we want to build. If we are going to be building brand new precincts, they take a lot of time and they take a lot of money. So we need to be getting prepared now. So I think it does have the opportunity to be one of the best games, but at the moment, it's not looking like it.
The thing is, it's frustrating for Olympians like yourselves, obviously, but also the public. I mean, we saw what happened with the Commonwealth Games in Victoria. That was an absolute disaster. Now this, is politics just getting in the way of good sports?
I am worried that politics is getting in the way of sport, and we have an election coming up in October. Our state elections are up, and it's certainly very evident that this is all about winning votes. It's not looking good at the moment for Stephen Miles, unfortunately. It's just been so challenging throughout all of this, as the public as well, as Olympic athletes. They're focused on Paris. They're not concerned whatsoever about this. They've got one focus, and that's all that they're worried about. So this won't be concerned the current group of athletes, but it's certainly concerning the Brisbane residents, because we are living through this, we are hearing it every day, and the residents are really disappointed and really concerned about the future of this beautiful city. How much is it going to cost? What's the longevity of it? We need transport. We have had so many people move to this beautiful state of ours, and we need better transport, and we need so many more facilities. So I understand the concern, especially from Brisbane residents, about this, and we have so much on our plate. 8 years is a long time, and things may change economically in that time, but at the moment we're in a sticky position.
Well, I guess the concern as well becomes, I know everyone, as you say, is preparing for Paris right now, but when you hear about gold medals potentially being impacted in 2032 because there aren't the training facilities available in Brisbane for them, that's alarming.
That is alarming, absolutely. We are one of the best states in terms of sporting performances, especially for the swim team. I can talk about that personally. We have so many athletes that come from Queensland, and we do have some great facilities that are being built. There is a great throwing centre for the athletics, track and field. So there are small things being made, but we certainly need some of the best facilities. Mm. I personally competed in Beijing, where we had the Water Cube, which was a world-class facility for swimming, and also the Birdcage for athletics. I mean, I've seen some of the best of the best, but I've also seen Athens, which in 2004... however many years later, it's just become ruins. It's 20 years and the place is in ruins. So we can't be seeing that in terms of we need longevity and to be have a city that we're proud of. Absolutely. And to have some great facilities.
Liesl, thank you so much for your time this morning.
Thank you.
A new twist in the Brisbane Olympics debacle this morning. Athletes now warning our chances of winning medals on home soil will be crippled. Today, Queensland reporter Andrea Crothers has the latest. Andrea, the Miles government is copping it from all angles.
Yeah, Carl, they sure are. There's growing frustration among athletes that the QSAC plan, the former QE2 stadium, could hurt our chances of going for gold. Their main concern revolves around the Queensland Academy of Sport. It's a high-performance training facility located here, which would have to be demolished under that plan, meaning our athletes would actually have to go and train interstate. It was a $10 million world-class facility only opened 2 years ago. And while the athletes are turning up the heat, the political gymnastics continues. Premier Stephen Miles refusing to admit in Parliament that they considered axing the Games.
We don't discuss what is discussed in Cabinet, and I don't intend...
Order!
I don't intend to do so.
Order!
Here today.
Member for Theodore.
Either.
The International Olympic Committee has also weighed in, describing any suggestion of cancelling the Games as mere speculation, even suggesting it was fake news. Important to note, they were not in Cabinet, Carl.